I've literally just brought a PowerPoint to bars, being like, hi, you want to learn about keyboards? I'm the worst.
You've done that?
I have done that. So I love mechanical keyboards. I think they are so fun, and it's a great way to customize your desk, customize your programming, customize your life. And so what's cool about them is they are really reminiscent of the past, actually. With mechanical keyboards, they kind of came to be in particular because people wanted a return to quality. Where in the 80s with the IBM Model M keyboard, those keyboards still work today and they are great. I actually have a friend who uses a keyboard that was made on the day he was born, which is wild. And with all of these keyboards that were made in the 80s, because they still work, they're awesome, but they took a lot to manufacture. And so as computers were getting more popular, keyboards became more popular and more cheaply made. And so because they were more cheaply made, they would fall apart after a couple of years. Enter mechanical keyboards. And as people started playing around with the mechanical keyboards, saying, oh, what if I customize this, customize that, it became a hobby. And so this is a keyboard that I built, for example, where I laser cut the case myself. I soldered the PCB electronics in there. I picked out the switches. I programmed it. I added the keycaps. Those are all the different parts of the keyboard. And it is exactly what I would want in a keyboard. And I have a bunch of different ones. And it's fun because every single one is unique. It feels different. It looks different. But they're going to last me decades if I want them to, because they're built to last. This keyboard is called a White Fox keyboard, and it has Zelio switches, and so they're tactile but a little bit heavy. And what's fun about this one is they have the White Fox keyboards and the Night Fox keyboards. And so the White Fox is white, the Night Fox is black. And so my husband got the other one, and I got this one, and we swapped out the colors. So the Night Fox typically has the red keys, and the Night Fox typically has the blue ones, and we swapped. And it's fun to be able to have these keyboards that are like kind of matching but kind of different. This keyboard is called a Planck keyboard. It's a 40% keyboard, meaning it has 40% of the typical keys that you'll see on a larger keyboard, and it's orthogonal, meaning it's a grid. And so the theory is that because it's a grid and your fingers don't have to splay out, it's better for your hands because your fingers move up and down, and it has different layers of the keyboard. So you might notice there's no number row on it. If I hit this button, suddenly this layer becomes a number row. And it's kind of like the layers of keyboards on your phone, but it's built into this nice, very clicky keyboard that I built. So this may look like a keyboard, but it's actually a switch tester. And so this has a bunch of different mechanical keyboard switches, because the switches, which are the mechanisms that go up and down and make contact with the electronics, can be customized to the nth degree. You can add different springs, you can lube them and grease them to make them move smoother. And there's three different types. There's clicky ones, like this. There's linear ones, which are very smooth up and down, like this. And then there's tactile ones, which have a nice little thock, like this. And this is just a grid of a bunch of different switches. There's hundreds of types of switches out there, and you can really customize them to get the exact feel you want while you type. And whatever makes you more satisfied while you type, you should use.